Good afternoon. On behalf of the Frank J. Guarini School of Graduate Advanced Studies, it is my pleasure to serve as host for our annual Investiture Ceremony and to welcome you all, Dartmouth faculty and staff, family and friends, members of the Upper Valley community, and of course, our graduating PhD and master's students. This is a historic time of almost unimaginable change. None of us could have predicted 4 months ago that this ceremony would need to be remote, that all our lives would have been tossed into disarray by a global pandemic, and that the United States would be grappling with long-standing issues related to social injustice. I expect all of you have felt a wide variety of emotions over the past months: anxiety, fear, anger, sadness, disbelief, and helplessness. I know I have. But as you transition from one stage of life to the next, I would ask you to also share my sense of hope and optimism. I am confident we will learn lessons from the events of this spring that will make our society safer and stronger as we look to the future. And I am both delighted and proud that you are part of that future. Your hard work over the past few years, coupled with the training you have received, have prepared you not only to push the frontiers of knowledge, but to approach problems from multiple angles. You know how to think outside the box. You have mastered the power of using scientific process to discover truth about our world. You are critical thinkers. And while you now stand among the academic elite, you have learned to communicate effectively with a broad audience. The vital importance of these skills has never been clearer, and I cannot imagine a finer group of thoughtful leaders ready to take their place in this world. The issues before you are large, and addressing them is no small task. I know your paths will not always be easy, but I also know you are up to the challenge, and I'm excited to see what you will achieve as you leave Dartmouth and help to shape our future. It is now my pleasure to introduce Professor of Engineering and Dartmouth Provost Joseph Helbley. Before becoming provost, he served for 13 years as Dean of Dartmouth's Thayer School of Engineering. During the 8 years I've been dean, he has not only been a great colleague on the leadership team, but has been an invaluable source of advice and wisdom. He is a strong advocate for graduate students, and I'm delighted to have him with us today.
Thank you, Dean Kuhl. To all of our 2020 master's and doctoral graduates, it's my pleasure and privilege to join you today to celebrate all that you have accomplished. As every speaker, every family member, and every friend will no doubt mention, you have finished your Dartmouth degrees at an extraordinary time, at an unprecedented time, at a time of great unrest, unease, and anxiety, and in a time of pandemic. A pandemic that's caused us to rethink so many things at a fundamental level. It has caused us to rethink how we work, how we interact with one another, and how we communicate. This last point is perhaps obvious as you've interacted with your advisors through Zoom, reviewed documents by email, which I acknowledge you might have done anyway under normal times, and of course, as I speak with you through a screen from a very quiet Dartmouth campus rather than gathered with you and all of us together in Spalding Auditorium. You've mastered your subjects undaunted by this challenge. You've demonstrated your skill to advisors and committees, and you may have even defended your thesis from a room in your home. All of this unimaginable just 3 months ago. My point is that you've adapted, you've persevered, and you have communicated effectively in new ways. And it's this mastery, this ability to communicate effectively despite all of this disruption, to find new ways to use your voice, that may in the end be the most important lesson you have mastered in your time here at Dartmouth. Your voice is and will always be your most powerful tool. It will be the tool you use to stay connected with your professors, with your classmates, with your family, and with your friends. But most importantly, it will be the tool that you use and can use and should use to have meaningful impact on the public debate. We're entering a world where there are so many avenues for one's voice to be heard. This has opened the door to a culture where facts are disputed and misinformation, some might say, is rampant. This pandemic has shown us firsthand how quickly and broadly misinformation can spread. But your degrees and your subject matter mastery give you credentials. And this is why it is so important for you now to utilize your voice. You've become experts in your discipline, and because of this, your voice carries weight. Your voice carries with it years of research, countless hours in the lab, and a Dartmouth education. Many people can talk about a subject, but few can truly call themselves experts as you now can. As leaders in your fields, I hope you will embrace your responsibility to share your unique knowledge with the world, to correct bias when you see it, to speak out when you can, and to help all of us reach towards a better informed world. Gently correct an argument. Offer a scientific opinion in conversation. Speak to a school group. Volunteer at a museum. Write an op-ed. Perhaps even someday run for office. Do not be afraid to add your voice to the public dialogue, because I guarantee you have something meaningful to say. And I look forward to hearing from you and hearing your voice in the years ahead. Congratulations to all of you on the completion of your studies and the receipt of your graduate degrees. And now I'd like to invite Dean Kuhl back to the podium to present the Crosdale Teaching and Community Awards.
Thank you, Provost Helbley. The Hannah T. Crosdale Scholar Award is presented to the graduating PhD recipient who best exemplifies the qualities of a scholar. These individuals possess personal qualities of intellectual curiosity, dedication, and commitment to the pursuit of new knowledge, as well as to teaching. The award honors Professor Hannah T. Crosdale, who performed research and taught biology for more than 40 years at Dartmouth. She was the first woman to achieve the level of full professor in the arts and sciences. Selecting candidates from the volume of nominations submitted is both a deeply gratifying and remarkable process. Gratifying because the breadth and depth of achievements of the exceptional scholars in the Guarini School programs is presented as a snapshot in the recommendation letters from mentors, in the extensive CVs of each nominee, listing papers, patents, publications, and more, and in consistently outstanding academic records as presented in the transcripts under review. And it is a process that is remarkable from the perspective of narrowing the choices to just one Crosdale recipient. This year proved an even greater challenge than most, and two candidates were chosen for their deep commitment to academia, their creativity, and tenacity as leaders in their fields. We are delighted to announce the 2020 recipients of the Hannah T. Crosdale Award are Catherine Von Herman from the Program in Experimental and Molecular Medicine, and Amoga Tatamedi from Engineering. Catherine Von Herman is one of those rare individuals capable of elevating the bar for every challenge with determination and compassion. She joined Dartmouth with an already strong academic and research pedigree, having completed a BS and MS in biological sciences from Smith. She readily immersed herself in the academic and community life at Dartmouth and took a position on the Guarini Graduate Student Council as finance chair before being elected to serve as president of the executive board by her peers the following year. She has also contributed to the athletic endeavors of local K-12 students by serving as a ski instructor at the local Alpine Ski Program and has served as an outstanding mentor to the undergraduate community at Dartmouth. All this with the same professionalism and rigor that drives her academic endeavors. Having spent a year working in biomedical research in San Francisco, Catherine was determined to pursue high-quality, research-driven interventions for unsolved diseases, and her outstanding research accomplishments have been the hallmark of her time at Dartmouth. She has received academic awards and accolades every year, both locally and nationally, and has made significant contributions to research in the progression of Parkinson's disease, significantly shedding new light on how a previously miscategorized molecular mechanism does, in fact, contribute to the rapid neural degeneration for which this disease is known. According to her mentor, the magnitude of her thesis research is the closest thing to a paradigm shift discovery that he has been part of, and states, her studies will provide a foundation for the international Parkinson's research community for years to come. We are delighted to honor Catherine with this award and wish her every success in her future endeavors. Amoga Tatamedi's intellectual tenacity and generosity of spirit earned her a reputation as a model scholar and mentor during her time at Thayer. She has impressively embraced opportunities to share her knowledge with others through a range of activities and events, including volunteering to serve as a teaching assistant to undergraduate classes, which is not mandatory at Thayer, to organizing numerous symposia, giving her time to serve as representative at several outreach panels and events, and mentoring undergraduate students from their first year through to their thesis level. Amoga's enthusiasm and academic curiosity extends through her research achievements. She began her academic career with a publication that was one of the top 10 most cited articles for that journal, and now her publication record runs to 10 published journal papers, including 7 first author scientific and review articles. Her work continues to make significant contributions to the field of technology translation, and the outcome of her thesis research, which explored DNA capture technology, is a low-cost DNA sensor that could significantly impact clinical and point-of-care diagnostics. Amoga is a research leader within her field, wrote one of her nominators, and her impressive range of internships, consultancies, and scientific research experiences is a remarkable testament to her eligibility to the Crosdale Award. We are delighted to present Amoga with this prestigious award in recognition of all she has accomplished and in support of all she has yet to achieve. Congratulations to both Catherine and Amoga. And now I will present the Guarini Teaching Award. The Teaching Award is presented annually to the individual who best exemplifies the qualities of a college educator. The recipient is selected from nominations submitted by the faculty. If ever there was a year where flexibility in planning and delivery, an ability to pivot from one platform to another, and a capacity to mentor with compassion and empathy under trying circumstances was highly valued, then 2020 undoubtedly fits the bill. And we are delighted to honor Evan Dethier with this year's Teaching Award. Evan began his teaching career at a ski-focused high school in Vermont, where his meticulously structured and planned semesters of lessons and curriculum quickly went downhill, so to speak, as he discovered his classes would be lower in priority for his ambitious skier students. From a carefully mapped out design, Evan quickly revamped his material in response to his students' variable and unpredictable schedules while still achieving the academic rigor and knowledge demanded of them. Bringing this remarkable talent to Dartmouth, Evan, who works in the Earth Sciences Department, was quickly recognized, and he has been the recipient of multiple awards and honors for his teaching work, which he has pursued with enthusiasm and dedication. More than serving as teaching assistant for 11 undergraduate courses since arriving at Dartmouth, Evan remarkably stepped up to support Earth Sciences faculty when unforeseen circumstances left a class without an instructor. He supported the transition of complex hydrology field labs to develop 7 online labs to meet the demands of the new virtual learning environment, and has demonstrated excellence in remote mentoring, calmly coping with technical issues experienced by the remote learners. In fact, Evan has demonstrated an excellence in mentoring and supporting undergraduates, peers, and colleagues alike that far exceeds that of others in a similar situation. We are proud to award such a talented individual with this year's Teaching Award. Congratulations, Evan. The Graduate Community Award is presented annually to the graduate student who best exemplifies a deep commitment to serving the Dartmouth community. Past recipients have been recognized for participation in student governance, service on campus-wide committees, and the development and promotion of programs that enhance the academic and social options of the entire community. The 2020 recipient is Jin Chong, a PhD candidate in cognitive neuroscience working with Professor Luke Chang. During his time at Dartmouth, Jin has offered his time and expertise unfailingly to those within the Dartmouth community, perhaps most famously as co-founder of the highly successful Line at CAF, a free mobile and web application for the ever-popular and now sadly gone King Arthur Flower Outlet located in Baker Library. Jin also served with the Magnuson Center for Leadership on the Student Leadership Board, where he worked to support a team of Dartmouth undergraduates to success in the prestigious New England Venture Capital Investment Competition. He has fostered a community of entrepreneurship and collaboration both on and off campus, hosting seminars, encouraging developing collaborative networks among alumni, graduate students, and undergraduates alike. As president of the Dartmouth Graduate Consulting Group, He has made significant community impact through pro bono consulting services to local businesses, supporting struggling Main Street retailers through optimizing their online and in-person reach. His academic work has been recognized by national and international groups for its excellence and innovation, and he currently leads seminars in social brain sciences here on campus. His academic and community outreach work is highly valued, and we are delighted to present Jin with this year's Community Award. Congratulations, Jin. I'd now like to introduce Dwayne Compton, Professor of Biochemistry and Dean of the Geisel School of Medicine, who will be presenting the John W. Strobain Award.
The John W. Strobain Medal for Excellence in Biomedical Research recognizes a graduating PhD candidate from one of the degree-granting programs in the medical school. The medal is given to a student who best exemplifies the qualities of a scientific leader based on personal qualities of intellectual curiosity, dedication, a commitment to the pursuit of new scientific knowledge and teaching, as well as a sense of social responsibility to the research community. This year, I am pleased to announce the award recipient is Caitlin Kowalski. Caitlin conducted her thesis research in the laboratory of Dr. Rob Kramer in the Department of Microbiology and Immunology, and earned her PhD in the Molecular and Cellular Biology graduate program. Caitlin entered the MCB graduate program in 2014 following completion of a Bachelor of Science degree in biology at Stonehill College, where she graduated magna cum laude. Working with Dr. Kramer, her thesis research combined molecular, genetic, and microscopy-based approaches to explain how the human pathogenic fungus, Aspergillus fumigatus, adapts to oxygen levels within patient lungs. Specifically, she conducted experimental evolution of this fungus under hypoxic conditions to observe specific morphological changes that the fungus employs to adapt to a low oxygen environment. During her graduate training, she has authored 9 peer-reviewed publications, 3 of which as first author. She has presented her work as talks and posters at national meetings, and she has been invited to present seminars of her work at other academic institutions throughout the United States. In 2018, she was awarded an individual National Research Service Award from the National Institutes of Health to support her PhD training. Dr. Kramer credits Caitlin's scholarship for, quote, opening new areas of investigation into the field of filamentous fungal biology and fungal pathogenesis, end quote. And he states that her data had the real possibility of informing development of the next generation of antifungal drugs. In addition to her scholarly contributions, Caitlin has served as mentor to several Dartmouth College undergraduate students for their honors theses, as well as multiple first-year MCB graduate students during laboratory rotations. She has also served as a graduate ethics facilitator and chaired the Principal Investigator in Training student organization. In addition, she is a highly sought-after tutor for the graduate student community on subjects of NIH grant applications, as well as the PhD qualifying exams. Please join me in congratulating Caitlin on completing an outstanding PhD thesis and as the recipient of the 2020 John W. Strobain Medal for Excellence in Biomedical Research. It is now my pleasure to introduce Professor Donald Pease, Professor of English and Comparative Literature, the Ted and Helen Geisel Third Century Professor in the Humanities, and Chair of the Master of Arts in Liberal Studies program. He will present the MALS Thesis Excellence Awards.
Thank you, Dean Compton. With generous gifts from Nicholas Byam Shaw and the Clyde and Diane Brownstone Foundation, the Master of Arts in Liberal Studies program inaugurated the Byam Shaw Brownstone Thesis Excellence Awards in 1999. The donors established the fund to recognize the outstanding interdisciplinary research to which each of the concentrations in the MALS program, cultural studies, globalization studies, general liberal studies, art and creative writing, is dedicated. The superb theses completed by this year's graduates made our selection of the 2020 recipients of the award at once quite difficult, yet extremely gratifying as a task. The 2020 Thesis Excellence Award in Globalization Studies goes to Morgan Hamilton for Dairylands. One member of the Mao Selection Committee describes Dairylands as the platonic ideal of a Master of Liberal Studies thesis. In this artfully crafted and scrupulously researched monograph, Morgan Hamilton draws upon methodologies from the disciplines of anthropology, environmental studies, history, and American studies to conduct a comparative analysis of the small-scale dairy farming cultures that have arisen across the states of Wisconsin, New York, and Vermont. The farmers she interviews are conscientious about land stewardship and anxious to sustain the cultural continuity of a way of life they find threatened by governmental policies that favor industrial-scale farms. In his letter of nomination, Morgan Hamilton's thesis advisor, Professor of History Matthew Garcia, praises Dairylands for bringing into the spotlight a world and a people crucial to our food system and the cultural heritage of North America. The Mouse Committee selected Sabina Hoskinson as the recipient of the 2020 Excellence Award in Art and Creative Writing for the novel Lotus Season. Lotus Season is a coming-of-age novel that explores the complexities and uncertainties of characters grappling with questions of morality, destiny, sanity, and love, and that dramatizes their different dilemmas and successes as they discover how wrong they can be about who they are, what they do, and want. A close observer of the physical world, yet able at the same time to monitor the internal dimensions of her characters, Sabina Hoskinson often puts herself at odds with casual assumptions about how an individual can grasp control of her experiences. After describing Lotus Season as a fully realized and full-length novel, the novelist Lel Lelchuk concludes his letter of nomination with the remark, "I cannot think of any student I've had who deserves this award more." The selection committee awarded Daniel E. Offsprung the 2020 Thesis Excellence Award in Digital Cultural Studies for his thesis titled Big Data Subjectivity. Now, as its title implies, Daniel Offsprung's thesis engages the rhetoric promoting algorithmic governmentality by questioning programmers' representations of big data as if it were itself a disembodied speaker. Jed Dobson, Daniel Offsprung's thesis advisor and author of the acclaimed monograph, Critical Digital Humanities, describes Daniel's work on big data ideology as one of the finest accounts he's read on this subject, and notes that his contributions have led to an invitation to speak to experts on the implications of his study, the Lacanian theory. In his letter of nomination, English professor Aidan Evans writes, "I am awed by the thesis that Daniel Offsprung has written, which is easily the best master's thesis I have ever evaluated in mouths, in digital musics, and in master's programs outside of Dartmouth." Ed Ting receives the 2020 Mao's Thesis Award in General Liberal Studies for his thesis titled Astrophotography, A Practical Guide. In his introduction to Astrophotography, A Practical Guide, Ed Ting points out that astronomy is one of the last hard sciences where the non-scientist can make significant contributions. And throughout this elegantly written and beautifully illustrated volume, Ting brings astrophotography down to Earth by showing what kind of telescope can best read and photograph the deep night sky. A faculty member on the selection committee describes Ed Ting's clarity of expression in explaining and dissecting the complexities of astronomy and astrophotography as the best she's ever encountered in a Mao student. His thesis advisor, the prize-winning New York Times journalist Chris Wren, also reaches for superlatives when he characterizes Ed Ting's photographs of deep space as breathtaking and hails Astrophotography, A Practical Guide as a publishable scientific treatise. And Macy Bailey is the recipient of the fifth and final 2000 Thesis Excellence Award in Cultural Studies for the visual activation of the American left's progressive fantasy post-2016. In this imaginatively composed, intricately argued thesis, Macy Bailey explores the psychosocial impasses that the election of Donald Trump posed for contemporary women protest artists. Macy Bailey deftly collates interpretive paradigms from the disciplines of cultural studies and Lacanian psychoanalysis to conduct close readings of images and installations by white and women of color artists whose artifacts promote the possibility of hope and transformative political action after the shock of the 2016 election. In nominating Macy Bailey for the Thesis Excellence Award, the eminent American Studies scholar, Jean Rosenthal, writes, quotes, "Overall, this thoughtful, outstanding exploration pulls together the different strands of interpretation by expertly presenting art in the service of political resistance." I should add that as her thesis advisor, I consider Macy Bailey's the most accomplished thesis that I have directed in over the past 20 years. Now I will hand over to Dean Kull, who will introduce the 2020 Guarini Investiture student speakers.
Thank you, Don. Each year we select two student speakers to offer advice and insight to our graduates. Our first speaker is Daniel Afsprung, who is a student in the Master of Arts in Liberal Studies program.
Hello to all faculty, friends, and families, and to my fellow graduates of the Guarini School of Graduate and Advanced Studies. It seems necessary to address the way this investiture is taking place. My first instinct was to dwell on the challenges and compromises of a distant ceremony and try to reimagine it in some way that would fix it, looking on the bright side or inventing one. Then I wanted to offer some profound lesson, which seemed to require that I dwell on the negative, to indicate a way we could learn from this, but we've all done our fair share of learning already. Investiture means today we will be invested with the title. Sometime soon we will also get a diploma in the mail, and students sometimes joke about all the work they are doing for that piece of paper. But if the diploma was what this was all about, how would today be different from a normal investiture? We would still just wait for the real thing to arrive. What relation does today have with the button someone will click somewhere that gives us that title? Is it about the granting of safe passage to CVs and resumes that include the fateful few letters we've worked so hard for? What is the real difference between this ceremony and that of any other year? Why does it feel different? Do we all just secretly love caps and gowns? The caps and gowns are symbolic, of course, and although it might seem like today is all about the new title, I think the ceremony is actually symbolic of something else. Otherwise, it might all seem a bit excessive, all this fuss over a piece of paper. Today is about the letters, it is about the piece of paper, but these in turn are about something else, something much larger. The heart of the ceremony, not the surface with its pomp and circumstance, but the form of the thing itself, is really very simple. We're sitting together in acknowledgement, just as we would be if we were in Hanover. We take this time to sit, rather than just awaiting the diploma, for the same reason we use the letters. The thing we are trying to represent here is too big to talk about. The letters transform our work, our grades, into a title. The ceremony transforms our years into a few hours. We make these changes because there's no way to share the real thing. No one has the whole picture, though partners, parents, friends, and siblings have seen a lot, that's for sure. We're doing the ceremony when we sit in recognition of this, in recognition of how laughably small the letters are, how thin the piece of paper. The ceremony is an admission that we do not and cannot know all these symbolize. They may look the same, but they mean something different to each of us. Ceremony is bearing witness, and we can do that from anywhere. We point our attention for a short time towards what there is no time to say, what has disappeared into the old drafts, the hours spent in the lab, the mistakes, and the do-overs as much as the triumphs. This beautiful ability we have to turn one thing into another, what gives us poetry, art, mathematics, our very names, is what is at work here today. The ceremony is a time where things are what we believe they are, And I, for one, believe that we do acknowledge greatness by this small act, sitting down and taking a moment together in admiration of the work of Guarini's 2020 class of graduates. Thank you for being here, and congratulations to you all.
Thank you, Daniel. Our second speaker is a PhD student from Microbiology and Immunology, Kimberly Ann Marie Lewis.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to one of, if not the most unconventional, investiture ceremonies that Guarini School of Graduate and Advanced Studies has ever held. Congratulations to the graduating class of 2020. We did it. Although global events of recent months have challenged and revolutionized the way education is obtained, all graduating classes of 2020 have shown the world how resilient and dedicated we all are in advancing our own education. But to you, my fellow Dartmouth graduates, I want to impart a message on being fearless, ethical, and kind as we embark on our careers. Let us be cognizant of the fact that time and again, we will feel fear and intimidation. However, it is up to us to not let this fear limit our success in life. It is up to us to be bold and to be strong in our convictions. It is up to us to remain fierce in the pursuit of our dreams. Let us stay hungry, graduates. Never forget how adaptable we are, as is evidenced by our rapid change in protocol during this once-in-a-lifetime global pandemic that has allowed us to round out our Dartmouth education on a resounding high note. During the pursuit of our goals, let us never compromise on the ethical values that our graduate studies at Dartmouth has instilled in us over the years. Instead, let us use these values to maintain our integrity and reinforce our ethical boundaries. Let us protect that integrity at all costs while remaining true to ourselves. But above all this, and most important, let us be kind and live a life of significance, a life that enriches the lives of those around us, a life that establishes positivity in the world. I will leave you with a quote from Winston Churchill, and I hope we will all remember this quote as we face our future challenges and the rest of our lives. He said, "Success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts." Congratulations to you, my fellow Guarini School graduates. Let's go do Dartmouth, ourselves, and our families proud.
Thank you, Kimberly. It is now my distinct pleasure to introduce Philip J. Hanlon, Dartmouth Class of 1977, Professor of Mathematics, and Dartmouth's 18th President. In my first conversation with President Hanlon in 2013, he expressed to me his vision for Dartmouth, which included establishing a school of graduate and advanced studies. And today, because of his efforts, support, and guidance, his vision of the Guarini School of Graduate and Advanced Studies has been achieved. President Hanlon, thank you for everything you have done to support graduate students at Dartmouth, and thank you for giving today's closing remarks.
Good afternoon. It is my profound pleasure to be joining you virtually today as we celebrate you, our most recent graduates from the Guarini School of Graduate and Advanced Studies. Congratulations to each of you on earning your master's or PhD. I can still remember my feelings as I sat, about to be hooded as a new PhD at Caltech some 39 years ago. Gone was the exuberance of my undergraduate commencement. In its place, I felt a deep and quiet satisfaction for having achieved, after years of focused effort, the pinnacle of preparation within my field. You too should be feeling proud of your accomplishments today. But I suspect you may be feeling the opposite of quiet satisfaction. I expect you are feeling outraged, probably shaken, by the dark times in which we find ourselves. Continued injustice in our communities, a global pandemic, and a deep economic recession. a combination the likes of which this nation has never seen before. In this moment, you may be asking yourselves, how can we possibly be celebrating with the world in such turmoil? What can I do to fix the problems that are plaguing our society and the world at large? If you're asking yourself those questions, then I am beyond hopeful for our future. And I can assure you, today is indeed a reason to be hopeful. Now more than ever, society needs your intellect. It needs your unique understanding of the incredibly complex and downright difficult issues that threaten our world. It needs the unique abilities you've honed in pursuing your advanced degrees, your ability to apply logic and reason to arrive at meaningful conclusions, your capacity to understand the interconnected nature of economics, public health, the environment, and so much more. It needs your focused attention, and here you are, ready to provide it. This is your leadership moment. This is your moment to carry your knowledge to a world in dire need of unity, of solutions to complex problems, and above all, compassion for one another. And I know you are up to the task. On campus, we will miss you. And I'm sorry we didn't get a chance to say a proper goodbye. Throughout your time with us, you've brought us bold thinking and academic urgency with your hunger to make a difference in the world. You've helped bridge academic generations between our undergraduates and our faculty, serving as role models for young talent and inspiration for us elders, myself included, to continue pushing the boundaries of knowledge in our fields while you do just the same. Just know that on this day, I have pride and confidence in all of you. Congratulations once more on all you've accomplished at Dartmouth. May your brilliant intellect shine light in this world, and may your lives be full of success and happiness always.
Thank you, President Hanlon. Before concluding our ceremony, I want to wish all of our Guarini School graduates luck and success in all your endeavors. I look forward to reading about your accomplishments and hearing updates from you in the years to come. Congratulations.
Thank you.